Okay, for the lowercase a, start out with a palleted chiseled brush. Starting with our thin on the top, we're going to come around an arc and do our basic stroke. So starting out thin, down, counterclockwise, clockwise. And palette the brush again. Now we're just concentrating on this inside loop. We're not worried about where what the brush does at the end. We're just trying to make this loop right here look good. That right in there. Because then we're just going to come right off of this with a basic stroke, pushing down the brush, pull down a slight arc, counterclockwise, clockwise. Okay. In the B, in the direction of the stroke, a palleted brush, touch down, go in a slight arc, and as we get down closer to the baseline, start to let up and spin clockwise. Like that. So following slight arc, and then as we start to get down, let up on the brush and then spin clockwise. For the other side of the B, we're going to come up from that stroke on edge with a brush like this, in the same direction as the stroke, coming off with a nice great gradual taper off of that stroke, and we're going to spin around with our brush till we get to the position of the brush going in the direction of the stroke on this side. And then we're going to start to let up and meet the bottom stroke. So vertical brush, or not vertical, but in following the direction of the stroke, up, and then spinning clockwise, till we get to this point right here. Now we're going to start to push down and follow that stroke line. Now we start to let up, no spinning, and just meet that bottom line. Lowercase c is much like the uppercase, only it's the basic stroke on the bottom. So we start out with our thin, swinging around a nice graceful loop, and as we come down, counterclockwise and clockwise, spinning and letting up on the brush. Flatten our brush, pull our paint down and around just like the capital C in the direction of the axis, so keeping this thin. And then just pull in a nice, graceful loop and stop right there. Now palette your brush again. And holding the brush in this direction from above, we're going to pull down and meet that loop. So we're just going to take it and make a nice, graceful loop, pulling it around and meeting it. Now a little too wide. Okay, and then the D, we start out with a lowercase a, then stroke here, and then push down, arcing, counterclockwise, clockwise, let up to a taper. Same thing with this. We're just thinking about this inside space. Bring it around nice and graceful, trying to keep that thin stroke thin. I see how this is a nice even oval? That's what we're trying to get. So we don't have to think about this right here. And then you just bring that. This stroke down. Slight arc, and then a basic stroke So following, touch down. A little more paint on brush. Touch down. Kind of hold it there and then bring it down gracefully, gradually, counterclockwise, clockwise, let up. So there's kind of a slight arc when you come around this part of the D. And the lowercase e starts out with a basic stroke, much like the A. The thin on the top, pull it around, push down. This arcs a little bit more and start to spin counterclockwise, and now clockwise and let up. To bring that other one, we kind of want to round off the top. I want to try to round off this part of it. Round it here, and so we start out thin, horizontally, and then spin clockwise, and then back counterclockwise again. So to keep this thin, we could pull it over, down, and counterclockwise and letting up. Counterclockwise and letting up. Lowercase f. Has a long stroke from here all the way and descends, and then you start out following the stroke, and then you spin clockwise to the bottom point. So starting out following the stroke until you get down beyond the baseline and start spinning clockwise until you get to a nice little rounded taper. Not too sharp, just nice and just like that. It's a nice slight spin, slight counterclockwise spin. And then from this one, we'll start out following the direction of the stroke, and then we're going to spin counterclockwise to meet this point below. So we're going to start out following the direction of the stroke, coming down, spin counterclockwise, bring it around, and up. You start out with the in the direction of the stroke, and as you come down here, you're slightly spinning only to give you some more width, but then you're going to maintain. Then you're going to come back to that 45 degree angle this way to complete that stroke below. And then for the horizontal stroke, you're going to start out right inside of that point, and you're just going to push down, and we're going to taper up, we're going to lift up as we go through to make a blunt end, a blunt taper at the end. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to touch down with the corner of our brush at that point so that both corners finally meet. Then we're going to spin slightly. When you're in that corner, just spin slightly counterclockwise, start to pull, and then go back clockwise, and that will create that taper until your brush is horizontal. And the lowercase g is just like the uppercase g, only littler. And it starts out with a shape, lowercase a, the thin above, pull it around, push down, counterclockwise, start to let up quickly. And then we want to make that nice round. We're just thinking about this shape in here. Pull this around, make a nice shape there. A nice oval. And we're going to bring the descender. We touch down, go slightly to the right, and then back again, going in the direction of the stroke, start to let up, and start to spin counterclockwise. With a chiseled brush, we want to be real thin. Pulling from this inside of this stroke, we're going to come down, following the direction of the stroke, pushing down, and coming back around. We're never going to twist. We won't twist this one. Just keep it about in the direction of that stroke. Push down, and just bring it around and meet that stroke. And then you can finish off. This whip is just simply going in the direction of the stroke and just letting up very quickly, almost like just flicking your brush. So starting in the paint and then just flick it. Lowercase h comes down in the direction of the stroke. Clockwise to round that off. And we go ahead and make the other stroke in the same direction, but we're going to arc it slightly. And then we're going to do this basic stroke. Touch down, bring it down, arcing slightly, counterclockwise, clockwise, letting up. Letting up quickly. Then we're going to touch down corner to corner with the brush on edge in the direction of the stroke. Okay, the eye is a basic stroke. Touch down. Bring it around, slight little arc. Counterclockwise, clockwise, let up. To make the dots, we want to make the dots the same width as the stroke, same thickness, so it's uniform. And that's simply making two half ellipses. So what I do is I just start up about above, just above the eye where I want it to end up, start and end up. And just make a left ellipse so it's lined up with the edge of this stroke, and then a right ellipse that's lined up with this edge of the stroke, and that keeps me within the stroke. So just touch down, push left and down, and go up, do the same thing, push right and over. And that gives you that controls your width of your dot. J starts out following the stroke and then spinning counterclockwise to a taper, just like the G. So we touch down, pull down, start to let up here, and spin counterclockwise to make that taper. Starting out, finishing it off with the brush going in the same direction on edge, and just keeping it in that position until you meet that bottom corner, that loop. Pulling it down, push down here, and start to let up here. And then to make that into that whip, just flick your brush. And this dot is done exactly the same as the eye. So you just hold your brush on the corner, right in the center. Make a left ellipse and then a right ellipse. Push down, left, and down. Keep trying to keep this edge along the lines of that edge. Push down, over, and down to meet that. That gives you a nice shape. Lowercase k starts with your basic axis stroke. So we touch down, bring it straight down the direction of the axis, clockwise, to make a nice round off. that loop is very small. And so what we're going to, how we're going to do that is start out with the brush just at a slight angle, and then we're going to follow it a little bit until we get to this point where it needs to be thick, and then we're going to be horizontal, and then we're going to spin our brush slightly clockwise. So we're just going to be constantly spinning slightly clockwise as we make this stroke all the way around. But we're never going to go to 45 degrees in either direction, just very little. So we're just basically trying to follow the direction of the stroke, except for at this point where it needs to be thick. So we just pull it in, over, put pressure down, 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 down. Now start letting up. And spinning clockwise. That makes that loop. Then we're just simply, for the leg, we're just going to make a basic stroke. Starting from this inside corner, come down counterclockwise, clockwise, let up quickly. The lowercase L is a very long basic stroke. We're going to start out making a thin and kicking over and bringing it down along the axis, along following that arcing stroke. So we start out with a thin stroke on top, pull it down. Nice, graceful slope, counterclockwise, clockwise, let up. Pallet your brush, grab some paint if you need to, and then round this off. Nice little round, and then we're going to come down and we're going to spin counterclockwise to make this taper. So we're not only going to spin counterclockwise, we're just clockwise, but we're just going to let up slightly. And you can go all the way through if you want, or just stop. Coming around, spinning counterclockwise, and lifting up off the brush. And if you wanted to go all the way through, you can just make a little whip at the end. And the lowercase M is making these short axis strokes. So starting from here, you just touch down, pull it clockwise, round it off, do it again, parallel with that stroke, touch down, parallel with that stroke, clockwise, round that off. Now this final one will have a slight curve to it, like the front side of the A, like in a basic stroke. So touch down, slight little curve, counterclockwise, clockwise, let up. But it's still parallel with these other strokes. And pallet the brush, go on edge from corner to corner, your connecting strokes. Corner to corner, your connecting strokes. The N is half of an M. So basically we're going to do a short axis stroke. Touch down, bring it down, clockwise. Round that off. And then, just like the M, touch down and make a nice, graceful sweep. Counterclockwise, clockwise. Connecting stroke, on edge brush. Meet the other corner. Keep the O narrow. Don't go too wide with that. It looks better if it's a little narrower than a super wide O. And so basically we're making two half ellipses. And we're going to start out with the thin on top. We're going to start out thin, going this way. Spin slightly clockwise until we get down to the end, where we taper off. So we're going to arc, we're going to push down and let up. So we're light, start pushing down, and then let up. Light, start pushing down. Now start letting up. And end with this taper to zero. Same with the other side. We're going to do the exact same thing, only going the other way. Thin on the top. Pull it around. Start pushing down right here. And now start letting up and spinning counterclockwise. P. I'm going to pull that stroke straight down past the baseline, and then we're going to spin it clockwise. Touch down, pull along the axis clockwise, and round it off. Now we're going to pull that up and around, and then back down to the baseline. So we're going to start out in the direction of the axis with our brush, and then we're going to make a nice taper here and a thin stroke, and we're going to follow that around. We're going to spin our brush clockwise, spinning clockwise, coming around until we meet this point where our brush is going in the direction of the axis. And then as we come down, we're going to taper around. We're just going to spin slightly counterclockwise. So we're going to pull up out of this stroke, nice and thin, following it around, following, spinning the brush clockwise, spin. Now push down and follow the stroke. Now start to let up and level and make it horizontal. So your brush is just about horizontal at that point, at this point. And then we're going to go ahead and pallet our brush, and we're going to pull this stroke down. I'm going to pull this stroke down, the same thing, but we're going down vertically. I mean, in the direction of this stroke. I'm going to pull it down and just meet that stroke around. So it will contract itself as we do this. So it'll be a little thinner than the thick stroke, and just pull it around and finish that off. Okay, the Q starts out as a lowercase a. So get our thin stroke at the top. Pull up and around and over and down. Counterclockwise, clockwise letting up and going all the way up. Now we're going to go ahead and do that round off stroke. And what we're going to try and do is follow that stroke, keeping that thin, and we're just going to try and make this inside loop right here real nice, a nice round loop inside. That's our goal. Nice round loop, like that. See, it's a nice uniformed loop. Now, I don't even think about this because it's irrelevant. It's going to be covered. And then we just pull this down, straight down, following that stroke. Touch down, pull it straight down, clockwise, round it off. Now after we round this off, we're going to do a little whip, nice little tail that's going to come up just above the baseline. So we're going to bring it, our brush is going to be absolutely in the direction of the stroke this way, and as we come up, we're going to taper off and up. We're going to whip it off, clear off the panel. So we start out inside of this, pulling it up, and whip like that. That makes the Q tail. You're just kind of going in the off to the right slightly. Okay, there's a couple of different styles of R. One looks more like, to me, like a casual, where the other one is more like a script. And this is pretty much just basically starting out with a basic stroke that comes down, follows the axis, and spin clockwise and round it off. And then to make the to make that little stroke for the R, you start out this inside this stroke, come up and taper out of there with a nice thin stroke, making a round and coming back into that taper as close as you possibly can, because you want this thin stroke to be thin, and then this little nodule just to be a very small little nodule. So it starts out in the stroke, in this first stroke we did, in the same direction of the stroke, and then just follow your arc. Whoops. Okay, so then you just come up and make a little loop and come back and go back into that stroke. Now, for this alphabet, I prefer this next R, which to me fits more of the script. It's a little bit more elegant, I think, and just seems to fit more, but you can use any R you want. So the way I do this R is I start out to making this first stroke on the axis with a brush at a 45, so you don't want this to be really thin. It's a little thicker than just the edge of your brush. So at a 45, just drop down at this secondary line, just drop down and follow the axis. So the brush is at a 45, but I'm going to come down on the corner of the brush. So it's coming down on the corner of the brush and pulling down like that, just to make a little thicker stroke than a thin stroke. And then to make the other stroke of the front stroke of the R, and what you do is you come at the same 45 degree angle, but you're going to touch down with this corner of the brush, this one here. You're going to touch down, pull it over with a slight arc, you know, a top arc that goes whoop like that, not like that, I'm just showing exaggeration. And a slight arc, and then come around back into this stroke, turning it clockwise to follow the axis, and then you're going to make a basic stroke. So you drop into the corner of this at a 45 degree angle, drop in, pull it a nice little arc, now start to spin clockwise in order to get onto this axis, and then just come down and make a basic stroke. Counterclockwise, clockwise. And you've made your R. This comes out a little bit. Okay? And then the S also has two in this alphabet. Both the digital and in the book. The R and the S are in there. And this first S basically is, again, more like a casual S, in my opinion, my humble opinion. And basically it just comes around. It starts out basically like the capital S, to come around, you know, first to make your thin stroke, then you come down, and then you spin back around clockwise in order to make this bottom stroke. So we start out with our thin, up, coming down, pushing a little harder. Now start spinning clockwise to make that in stroke. I mean, to make that base stroke. And then could probably pull off going all the way around and completing that stroke in one shot. You could come down, as you're coming down here, you could come down to the end and then just pull your brush over like that. And you created that stroke, which is just simply keeping it in the same direction as the axis. So it's just keeping it in the same direction of the axis and just pull it over. And you may have to touch up this little end point, blunt it. You want it to be blunt like that. And then to finish off the loop is just like all the other ones. Come up and over and then spin your brush around. So you're going to keep, stay on this thin stroke, come, you're going to come down in the direction of the axis like that and stop, and then you're going to meet that stroke coming from the other direction from above, and you can really get a good, you know, angle. It's almost coming down from almost vertical, but not quite. And just fill that in. Now I prefer, again, this alphabet with this script or more cursive S. So this is the S that I use. I use this R and this S. And this one is similar to the R, starts out similar to the to this R, where it just, you start out almost 45. This is a little less of a thick stroke as the this R. And so you just drop down from the top, just pretty much follow the direction of the axis with with your brush on edge to create that thin line. And then to make the main stroke of the S, you go just above, just a hair above the line. And we're going to kick over to the right slightly. We're just going to slide over to the right and then slide back. And we're just going to keep this stroke all the way down, but we're not going to go to the baseline. We're just going to stop short of it. So we're going to start out touching down, kicking to the right a little, and then pulling back and start heading down almost vertical and stop. It's much easier to pull the other stroke around up into that than try to bring it up and around. So now we're going to go with a vertical brush. So our brush is vertical. We're going to touch down on the corner of this brush, this corner. This corner is going to touch down first. And then we're just going to pull down and around. And there'll be pretty much no spinning. So we touch down and pull up. Like that. And then there's no spinning. So it's always vertical, boom. And then to make that cross stroke, connecting stroke, we want it to be thicker here than here, but we don't want to come to a tapered point whip. It wants to be blunt here. So we're going to hold our brush at a 45 degree angle, and we're going to push down into this intersection and pull it over. And as we start to move right, we're going to spin clockwise to make a nice taper. So we start out 45, touch down in this intersection, pull the brush and start lifting up and spinning horizontal to make that point. And the T is pretty basic. Now at this point, we're going to do a basic stroke starting above the secondary line, following the axis, the brush going in the direction of the axis, touchdown, a slight tiny bit of a curve, camber, spin clockwise and let up. And to make the crossbar, we pallet our brush, make a chiseled edge, and then we just touch down because we got a nice chiseled edge. We touch down and we're going to make another blunt, just like we did with this S. We're going to make a nice blunt point at this end. So we touch down, pull right. And then just don't whip it up. Don't whip it. Just pull it over, and let up your brush slightly, to make a nice tapered crossbar. For the U, I know there's a thought of making that real loopy like a U, but it's really just a basic stroke with a hard corner at the hard inside corner, just like all the other basic strokes. It starts out following the axis, touch down, pull it around with a nice graceful arc, counterclockwise, clockwise, go all the way up. Now see, I did it right there. it just needs to be a nice, like that, like the basic stroke. And you don't have to go all the way up to the line. You just need a reference for your next stroke because you'll tie it in. So you just come starting from the secondary line, touch down, pull it down, make another stroke just like that, spin it around, counterclockwise, clockwise, let up. The V. V is much like the capital V, only the lower, you know, the base of the V isn't quite have that sharp angle to it. But it is have you need to know that it's not just the same axis as all, you know, it's not a 30 degree axis because it's a V, if you think of it. It's just, you've got to think of the fact that the V has been tilted, so it's not going to be the same angle as these. It's going to be less of an angle because of the letter shape. And so you come down clockwise and just round that off. But the the second stroke is done exactly the same way as the capital. So we're just going to start out with the brush on edge and just follow this around all the way until we get to this point. Then we're going to start spinning it counterclockwise. So we're just going to do just exactly like we did with the capital V, touching down, following the stroke with the edge of the brush. And once we get to right here, we're going to start spinning counterclockwise until we meet that corner. And then we're just going to make a hook to finish off this top stroke. Come around. Don't make that too big. And the W is done a little differently than the capital because it's two basic strokes rather than coming down like the V. So it's more like two U's. So we're going to start out coming down like a basic stroke. Spinning counterclockwise, clockwise, let up. And then the same with this one. Come down, counterclockwise, clockwise. And this you don't have to go all the way up because you're going to pull that stroke down. So now we're going to do the same exact thing we just did with the V. Whereas, we're going to follow the stroke on edge, following on edge, and then counterclockwise. Fill in that little nodule, a hook, and then the X is also starts with a vertical stroke with the basic stroke at the bottom. So we just touch down to make a nice start, pull it straight down vertical. Counterclockwise, clockwise. And then the cross stroke from that, we're going to start out with the brush horizontal. And we don't want to go too low either with this. Don't go too low. You want to cross it just a little above halfway point. It looks much better. If you cross it, we're going to start out with horizontal and we're going to come down here and then we're going to just stop and we're going to round it off down there. So it's just horizontal, touch down, pull above, come down, stop. And we'll just round this off. And then the Y is just like the capital Y. And we It's going to start out, and you know, we stay above the baseline with the upper portion of the Y. So we just start out following our stroke, basic stroke, counterclockwise, whip it up to the top. And then we're going to pull this down. Brush is in the direction of the stroke at the axis line. Come down, spinning counterclockwise and letting up the brush so we get the bottom. Touch down, pull down, counterclockwise, letting up. And we're going to start out in the direction of the stroke with our thin line, and we're just going to keep that all the way around till we meet this thin. Pulling down, push down here, and then let up as you come around. Let up as you come around. And then to create this whip, you start inside of that, pull up, and release and off the panel. Okay, the Z, the top bar of the Z has a slight arc to it, as does the center and the bottom. So every stroke has a slight arc to it. So we're going to start out with this stroke 45 degree to get a semi-thick stroke. We don't want it to be super thin or super thick, because this is the main stroke here in the middle. That's the thick one. We're going to spin around and go in the direction of the stroke until we get down to the bottom and spin back. So it starts out with a 45 degree angle with a slight arc. So we're going to touch down with the corner of our brush and pull it over and around. And when we get to that point, we'll stop. So touch down, slight arc, around, and stop. Now we're going to load up again. And then we're going to pull, this time we're going to come down slightly and then pull this down. And we're just going to go ahead and we're just going to barely spin the brush. We don't have to go too far, just a slight clockwise spin, not a full-on direction of the brush here. Just slight, come down, spin the brush counterclockwise, and then make a slight arc to a taper clockwise. So come down, start heading down, slight arc, counterclockwise, start heading over right, start spinning clockwise, and over. And keep in mind, and then we get a taper that off, that can just be cleaned up. Keep in mind that this portion has to be further to the left beyond this point, because it is an italic. So we got to make sure that this ends up further left than this point. And then we simply round this off with a flat brush. We simply give ourselves a nice little round off here with a flat brush, just to make a little weight right there.